Your Steve Jones Show podcast is loading now. The Steve Jones Show podcast is sponsored by Purdy Insurance. Visit Purdy Insurance on Market Street in Sunbury or visit online at purdyinsurance.com. Sports talk where your voice counts. This is the Steve Jones Show on News Radio 1070 WKOK. Now, from the Sunbury Motors Studio, here's Steve Jones.
Today's show brought to you by Purdy Insurance. Market Street in Sunbury. Go to purdyinsurance.com. Purdy's have served this valley for a decade. When I mean served, they've just given back. The Purdy Memorial Golf Tournament last Wednesday was a huge success. Between $20,000 and $30,000 raised for the Greater Susquehanna Valley YMCA. And when it comes to the insurance part, I don't care whether it's auto, home, life, business, whatever it may be, they're going to find the right insurance that fits you, and they're also going to make sure that it's the best price, and they'll search to find that best price. There's a claim, they go to work as if it happened to them. They're your partners in all of this. And again, that is Purdy Insurance, Market Street in Sunbury. Go to purdyinsurance.com. And we're in the Sunbury Motors studio, Sunbury Motors, 4th Street in Sunbury, Sunbury Motors Kia, Routes 11 and 15 in Hummel's Wharf. Time now for our play-by-play call of the day. On Friday, we felt justified in making this call.
Justify and Good Magic start to pull away from the others, and they're into the stretch. And it's Justify and Mike Smith turning for home in front. Good Magic and Jose Ortiz a length behind as they come into the final furlong. Bravazos down the center of the track, and then Audible on the inside, who's now up in a third. Justify a two-length lead as they come to the final 16th. Good Magic on the outside is second. Audible third toward the inside. Then it's still Regard. They're coming to the wire. He's just awesome. Justify has won the Kentucky Derby. It was very close for a second. Audible may have got there inside of Good Magic. Then it's still Regard in a final time of 2 minutes 4.20 seconds. He's still undefeated.
Larry Columbus with the call on NBC. On to the Preakness now, a week from Saturday at Pimlico, just outside of Baltimore. Big money contract for Matt Ryan, $30 million a year. Mike Conti covers the Falcons and is part of the pregame and postgame for the Falcons radio network and joins us now. Mike, welcome back. It's always great to hear you on the other end.
Hey, Steve, how are you?
Doing really well. Hope you are well. Matt Ryan's doing well with his new contract. Timing means everything, and the timing for a quarterback in this era could not be any better. It has nothing to do with anything. I mean, timing means a lot. His timing was right.
Yeah, I think a lot of people, a lot of fans are struggling with it because they see the number. They know it's a big number. Matt Ryan has not won a Super Bowl. He's come close, but he hasn't won it. What are you doing giving him $30 million a year, first NFL player to make that? But in reality, Steve, it's not that unfriendly of a deal for the Falcons, because if you look at the market that was set this year by the deals that Jimmy Garoppolo and Kirk Cousins received, these are not outrageous numbers. And quite frankly, Aaron Rodgers is going to get paid even more than Matt Ryan at some point later this summer. So it's always – I would hate to be an NFL general manager, because I'm sure it gives you a lot of heartburn knowing that such a high percentage of your salary cap is not just going to one position but one player. But in reality, if you want to have one of the top 10, 12 quarterbacks in the NFL, this is the kind of money that you're going to have to shell out. And I think what we've learned, Steve, is – it's very rare, almost a fluke, when you can go and win a Super Bowl with an average quarterback. I know there are the exceptions that prove the rule, and Brad Johnson and Trent Dilfer and maybe a few others, but that's extremely rare. So if you want to be competitive, you need to have an elite quarterback, and if you want to have an elite quarterback, you're going to have to pay $100 million.
Which then goes to the next part. You talk about it's actually a friendly deal in a lot of ways for the Falcons, because I believe it counts 10% against the cap this year. 12% right. next year. It isn't until the third year when it gets to 16%.
Correct, although that makes it tricky because the Falcons have done an excellent job over the last, say, 3 years drafting talent for their defense. Keanu Neal, Devondre Campbell, Brian Poole. I mean, you could go down the list. And the Falcons' defense is actually kind of evolving into a semi-elite defense. Grady Jarrett's a big part of that. He's another one, someone they got in the fifth round. Kind of reminds you a little bit, though, of the Seahawks maybe a year or two ago where they got into the position where they couldn't afford to pay market value to all the players that they drafted because they were playing out their rookie deals. So the Falcons do get some short-term flexibility. They were hard against the cap in free agency, and that's why they didn't really go out and make a move other than signing Brandon Fusco, a right guard who might be a backup, as it turns out, from San Francisco. They get a little more flexibility now. I think with Matt Ryan redoing this, they get maybe an extra $3 or $4 million with which to work, which is not really a whole lot now that we're at the end of free agency, but it will allow the Falcons to have a little bit more room if they want to make a decision and keep Jake Matthews, and that's obviously a key. You want to have a left guard protecting your, or a left tackle protecting your $100 million investment. But, yeah, come that third year of the deal, when it goes up to 16% of the cap, you either have to hope that league revenues have grown exponentially and the cap's going to go up, which is not a gamble I would make, or they're going to have some very, very tough decisions to make with their defense.
Exactly. And now we get to other parts. Cause, I mean, that's the tricky part, how to make all the parts fit with this. And that's what they need to do. But he's also a quarterback that has been, knock on wood, had tremendous durability.
Absolutely. Yeah, he's only missed two games in his career, which is remarkable, isn't it, for someone who's going into his 10th year in the league. So you do have to kind of hope that trend continues. It's not a gamble you necessarily want to make. The Falcons are in pretty good shape because Matt Schaub has given them a discount to stay here for another year, so they have a solid backup. But the problem is, Steve, you can't count on anyone to give you a hometown discount anymore. I think there was a little bit of optimism here in Atlanta that Matt Ryan likes playing here. He's been the face of the franchise. He's really been the component of this franchise that has kept them stable over the last 10 years, even as they made a coaching change. There was hope that maybe he'd give the Falcons a little bit of a hometown discount, but Tom Condon, his agent, was not interested in any of that. And again, all he had to do was point to the Jimmy Garoppolo and Kirk Cousins deals. So unless the Falcons get some help from some of these young guys that they've drafted, like Keanu Neal and Grady Jarrett and Devondre Campbell and Deion Jones, and I don't think you can count on that, they're going to be in a similar boat to where the Seahawks have been the last year or two, where they're going to have to either trade or jettison some good young defensive players because you just can't afford to keep everyone.
And the bottom line is, though, you can't afford not to go through this without the quarterback.
I mean,
that's why
I agree.
That's why timing means everything for him. Look, quarterbacks have always been highly paid. Always have, no matter what.
Yeah.
You can go to any era, they've always been highly paid. Here's the next part. Don't get all caught up in the guaranteed part and what's not guaranteed. When's the last time a quarterback didn't get all the money? Because they don't leave. Hey, I mean, exactly. I mean, it's not like, hey, he's going to make the team in his fifth year to make it. Did anybody out there, show of hands, think that the Saints were going to cut Drew Brees a few years ago when he signed that 5-year, $100 million deal and only $60 million was guaranteed? I mean, come on.
I mean, I agree. There was actually a pretty deep thought in New Orleans that they were going to let him walk, but the Saints were in salary cap prison. I mean, they were so far over the cap. Mickey Loomis really, really had some problems, couldn't get deals restructured, and they were really in deep trouble. But that is such an anomaly. You are right. Quarterbacks, unless there's something totally unforeseen with an injury or something off the field, they always play out their contracts. And that, I'm sure, will be the case with Matt Ryan. He had a press conference today, Steve, where he talked about wanting to play to age 42, which is certainly something he would be capable of doing if he plays out another 6 or 7 years. Like we said, he's only missed two games in his career. But I think part of it, again, is you need to have an offensive line that will protect you and make it possible for you to avoid injury. And that's where, you know, you could go to a Matt Ryan and say, well, how badly do you want to keep Jake Matthews? Are you going to give a little bit of money back to keep that protection at left tackle? You know, they went out, they were very aggressive in getting Alex Mack 2 years ago, which I thought was a big reason why they were able to take that enormous leap from 2015, where they missed the playoffs, to almost winning the Super Bowl in 2016. And again, these are things that quarterbacks have to wrestle with. You know, do you give back a touch of money here or there to make sure that you have people who can keep you protected in the pocket?
Then the other part, too, is the league is so close together. I mean, you look at the division they're in, those teams are all grouped together closely. I mean, in terms of competitiveness.
And you know what's really interesting, Steve, is if you look at the Saints, the Panthers, the Bucs, and the Falcons, what have they really concentrated on drafting the last couple of years and movement and free agency? I mean, you saw the Saints move up 12, 13 spots and give up a first-rounder next year to get an edge rusher.
Right.
These teams of the NFC South know you're going to see Drew Brees, Matt Ryan, Cam Newton, and Jameis Winston all twice a year.
Yep.
You need to boost your defense. You need to find good young defensive players. You need to spend your money on defense. And that's what we're seeing now in the NFC South. I mean, the Falcons overwhelmingly have drafted defense the last 3 years. And part of that's Dan Quinn being a defensive guy, and he knows the metrics, the height, the weight, the 40 time that he needs to have to do what he needs to do defensively. But I think part of it, too, is you've got to get to Drew Brees and Cam Newton and Jameis Winston. It's just a reality of the division, and a lot of other divisions of the NFL aren't like that.
Which brings me to the next part. You talk about money. If you're going to save money, get all your draft picks signed from the slot they're in and get them in there. How well did the Falcons draft to then maybe either solidify depth or maybe have somewhat of an impact early?
Well, I thought they had a really interesting first round in Ridley out of Alabama, because you still have Julio Jones and Muhammad Sanu here. You lost Taylor Gabriel, but I think more significantly, you lost Andre Roberts, who was their kick returner and was top 10 in the league in kickoff returns this year. The Falcons, it wasn't that long ago when they had Devin Hester as a really dangerous guy that no one wanted to kick to because you knew he could run it back. I think Ridley is going to be a big, big part of special teams in the kick return game in 2018. And Thomas Dimitroff and Dan Quinn have said as much. But the Falcons' strategy this year was really to go out and just get the best available player. They got Dietrich Sinnott out of South Florida in the third round when they really, really need a defensive tackle. They let down Terry Poe walk in the offseason, and Jack Crawford, the former Penn Stater, is coming off an injury, but they're really thin at defensive tackle, and they waited until the third round to make that pick because they wanted to go and get the best available player. They drafted a corner in the second round. They're solid at corner right now with Desmond Trufant, Robert Alford, and Brian Poole at the nickel corner, but they look at Oliver as a guy who can press Poole, maybe get some more time at that nickel corner and also be a part of special teams. So I thought they drafted well. It was an interesting draft. It's very unpredictable because we thought they were going to go with Taven Bryan and get a defensive tackle right away, and they did not.
Yeah, but I thought Ridley was a good pick for them. To me, I thought out of the gate, I looked at that, felt he was the best receiver in the draft, although I think there's a lot of areas he can be better. But still, I thought that was a good pick. And when you've got other guys around him, Sanu, Jones, he doesn't have to beat the guy. That helps.
At least not at first. Yeah, that helps. And I think it gives them insurance to Sanu if things don't go well with him negotiating at the end of this year. Contract is coming up. And, again, we talk about the amount of money that the Falcons have tied up in Ryan, but also in Julio Jones. A lot of money tied up in the two players. So they might be looking at Ridley as their number two of the receiver of the future next to Julio Jones and maybe taking a chance of letting Muhammad Sanu walk.
Hey, it's always great to hear you. Appreciate the time very, very much, Mike.
All right, Steve, anytime. Great talking with you as always.
Mike Conti from the Falcons Radio Network. Matt Ryan, a $30 million a year deal. He walked in, he said, look, I want to be paid like the suit. They buckled. Back with more in a moment on News Radio 1070 WKOK.
Here's Adam Purdy with another example of how Purdy Insurance is different.
I was at home one Saturday when I got a call from a client who had just been in an auto accident with a rental car in Canada. After confirming that everyone was okay, I checked his policy and assured him that we had the proper coverages in place. Within a few minutes, I had his claim called in and he was back to enjoying his vacation.
Purdy Insurance has been answering calls like this for over 90 years.
Give Purdy Insurance a call today at 800-677-2478 to see what we can do for you.
right, great to have you with us on the show today, brought to you by Purdy Insurance. Market Street in Sunbury, go to purdyinsurance.com. And we're in the Sunbury Motors studio, Sunbury Motors, 4th Street in Sunbury, Sunbury Motors, Kia Routes 11 and 15 in Hummel's Wharf. All right. Interesting testimony today before the Knight Commission on NCAA reforms. It took place, I want to say, in D.C. today by Kalia Carter, the mom of Duke basketball star Wendell Carter, who was opted, by the way, to forego his final 3 years of eligibility and enter the NBA draft. She compared the current NCAA basketball system to slavery and a prison system. She said, quote, "When you remove all the bling and the bells and the sneakers and all that," she said, "you paid for a child to come to your school to do what you wanted them to do for you for free. And you made a lot of money when he did that. You've got all these rules in place that say he cannot share in any of that. The only other time when a labor force does not get paid but somebody else profits, and the labor is black and the profit is white, is in slavery." Now remember, Kalia Carter did play basketball herself at Ole Miss. She said, "To be honest with you, it is nauseating." Donald Remy, the NCAA's chief legal officer, said the goal is to have the recommendations of the Rice Commission structured so they can be implemented by the next basketball season, saying this is not the NCAA as usual. Work has begun. It's a Band-Aid, but see, that's how out of touch they are. I mean, you hear a statement like that, it's a Band-Aid. What did you do as a Band-Aid? You didn't make any real reform. Come on. Been around this thing for almost 40 years, Don. All right? Stop sugarcoating it. If you wanted to open the door, you should open the door to allow them to use their likeness. Now, that's bold. Okay? That's bold, where the universities would not have to pay for it. That's bold. Okay? You weren't bold. You don't have the guts to be bold. You know, the NCAA has always been an organization there, okay, to be frank with you, has always been an organization that has taken the easy way out. Okay? Most times, the best decision is not the easy decision. The NCAA almost always has taken the easy position. Just my opinion. Carter played basketball, graduated from Ole Miss. She talked about her grandmother and her mother working in the cotton fields in Mississippi. "Should the NCAA be removed? Yes, because I don't trust it," she said. "You're not to be trusted because your intentions are clear. Let's call this group in the middle and let's call it something else. But let's put some real reform in there and call it something different. Get rid of the current status quo because it's based on indentured servitude." Now, this is the... We can debate the other parts. I mean, fine. But this is the part I found interesting. "You tell me it's about education, and we're giving you this fabulous education for your son to come to school here. So you're paying him with the education for his talent. If that's what you're paying him with education. Why aren't you making sure he gets it?" Right? Okay, well, stop there. Your son decided to take 1 year of it, probably gen ed courses, because most freshmen, I don't care what you are, whether you're playing sports or not, for the most part, you're taking gen ed courses your freshman year to get established and get the credits. Well, he decided to go to the NBA draft. Why aren't you assigning somebody to him so So if he is a one and done, why didn't you automatically assign him an academic advisor so that when he leaves, he can get someone in his ear talking to him about the value of education he left behind? Wendell doesn't have that problem because I'm going to be there like a jackhammer. But all these other kids, the thing you pay them to come to your school, they'll never get it. You know what? First of all, the NCAA does have in place that now you can go back to school on your scholarship, even if you turn pro, to get your education. That's there. It's also their responsibility. Hey? It's amazing how everybody else is not responsible, or everybody else is responsible except the person involved. Okay? You want to go back and get your education? Go back. It's being handed to you. It's your responsibility.
When it comes to car buying, there's the other guy's way, and then there's the SMC way. The other guys force you into a vehicle you really don't want. The Sunbury Motors way lets you take the time you need to browse, ask questions, and take the test drive and think on it. For over 100 years, the Mertz family and all their employees have made your experience the most pleasant one you'll ever have. The other guys won't offer you the best price for your trade, no matter how much they say they will. The SMC way is their promise to provide you with the most money the market shows your vehicle is worth. The SMC way is to offer you all applicable factory rebates on new vehicles and generous discounts. Looking for a pre-owned vehicle? The SMC way checks each vehicle in a 200-mile radius to determine the lowest price, then beat it. It's the lowest price promise, just part of the SMC way. The choice is up to you. The other guy's way or the SMC way? The SMC way wins every time. Sunbury Motors Company in the North 4th Street Auto Plaza, Sunbury, and at sunburymotors.com. Selling more cars and satisfying more customers for over 100 years.
Taking your calls at 800-795-9565. This is the Steve Jones Show on News Radio 1070 WKOK. Now from the Sunbury Motor Studio, here's Steve Jones.
Today's show brought to you by Purdy Insurance, Market Street in Sunbury. Go to purdyinsurance.com. Purdy's has served this valley for decades. Able to take care of auto, home, life, business, whatever it may be, finding you the best insurance so that you're covered at the best price that fits your budget. And if there's a claim, they're going to work for you right away. They are your partner. Purdy Insurance, Market Street in Sunbury. Go to purdyinsurance.com. We're in the Sunbury Motors studio, Sunbury Motors, 4th Street in Sunbury, Sunbury Motors, Kia Routes 11 and 15 in Hummel's Wharf. Kalia Carter says, paying the players will not solve the problem. She says, if you pay the players and kept the system like it is, it still would destroy them. It would just destroy them faster. That's not the solution. Don't get me wrong, it helps, but not without educating them on this process. All right, you do have to educate them on the process, obviously. But, you know, part of this is all, it's the responsibility of the individual to get the education, okay? It is also the responsibility, in my opinion, the NCAA has to be freer with the ability to make money off likeness, so there's that opportunity. I think the NCAA has done a great job with saying, okay, look, if you want to have your scholarship and come back at the age of 30, you can go back to school and finish then on scholarship. Great move. But the ability to educate them on what the steps and processes happen to be to get to the NCAA, to get to the NBA, part of this is an NBA thing, and also you have to allow them to have advisors. You have to allow them to have advisors. Then the follow-up question for her would be, okay, what would you recommend? If you leave school, you leave school. It's also your responsibility. It's also your decision. You leave school. It's also your decision to go back. It's also your decision. I mean, the avenue's there. So her testimony is a bit confusing, at least to me it is, because it takes away, again, It takes all the responsibility away from the individual. We're really good today about taking responsibility away from the individual. You got a brain, use it. Right? The brain tells you, okay, hey, look, I still want to get my education. How can I go about doing that even though I've just declared for the NBA draft? They've got people that will tell you how to do it. You have to ask. It's not their job to volunteer it to you. You left. You have to ask. You have to find out. Ask questions. Be inquisitive. Take responsibility. Oh, now Wendell Carter is going to be fine. His mother, obviously, as she said, is going to be there the entire time drumming home, hey, look, you're getting a degree. Right? I mean, so he's going to be fine because he comes from that kind of family with that kind of structure. So all credit to the Carters and to his mom. All credit to them. And it's not as if advisors are going to give you good advice all the time either. Some people are in it just for themselves. Others are in it because that's their business and they have people of legitimate care. But the individual has to take responsibility for their own deal. If education's really important to you and getting a degree is, you ask questions. Look, I want to go through the NBA draft process, right? It looks like I'm going to be a top 10 pick. All right, but I want to eventually get my degree. How do I go about doing that? How do I make that fit? And then everybody comes up with a plan. That's because you took the responsibility of asking. You can't have everything handed to you. You can't have, well, you know, the system really let him down. No, he let himself down if he didn't ask. No, it's your responsibility to do that. What do you think, Mike Krzyzewski doesn't care? Mike Krzyzewski cares. But Wendell, you know, let's take Wendell Carter out of it because obviously he's got a mom that's going to push hard to get him home, okay? I got that part. But other people along the way, if they want their education, it's your responsibility to go and do it. Find out how to do it. Ask somebody in the know what the process is to do it. You got to take it upon yourself sometime. You can't just be in the, oh, well, they all let me down. Oh, so it's everybody else's fault, but it's not your fault. Really? It's everybody else's fault, but it's not your fault. Even though you can go back to school anytime you wish on a scholarship and never have to pay for it and leave debt free. Even at the age of 35, you can go back and finish your degree. Now, whose fault's that? The system's or yours? As long as you're properly informed by people that you can do that, it's your fault. It's just so easy just to blame everybody else. It's like going into a staff meeting and hearing the digital media guys say that we're not doing enough to get stuff streamed. I mean, okay, come on. Just go sell. Oh, stop laughing.
Caught me. I do get worried, though. It just seems like we're now living in the period of where so many people younger than us, yeah, it's like the era of entitlement, you know. It gets frustrating. It's like, well, that's what you had to deal with during your time. Well, this is my time.
Well, okay. Let's take a different tact. Can I go to my academic advisor or tutor, of which, oh, by the way, every basketball and football team has multiple academic advisors. Okay, they all do. Let's schedule a meeting for 11 o'clock on Thursday morning. This is what I'm thinking of doing, but I still want my education. Can we come up with a plan? How much does that take? How much thought does that take to do that?
But that should be part of the process all along, right? That's really that's a no-brainer.
They should already have a relationship in place with the academic advisor. What courses do I take? How do I go about doing it? Right? And then, you know, if the academic advisor wants to sit down and say, hey, let's talk about your future. I know you're turning pro in the whole thing, but what about getting your degree just as a fallback? You'll find later in life that's going to be important. I mean, you know, they can be preemptive about that, too. But
I mean, I wasn't a student-athlete in college, but I look back at it now. I wish and I had opportunities to get tutors and work harder and strive for better grades, and I look back at it now, and I wish I should have took advantage of that, but it was a pride thing for me. I just felt like ashamed I would need the help. Not that I'm comparing my situation with those out there today that
Okay, but here's the next part. All right, say Wendell Carter doesn't think of it, you know, and obviously his mom has. Again, we're just using him as an example because I can't, you know, you can tell the mom is passionate about education, which is great. That's why I'd be shocked if he doesn't get his degree based on what she's saying. You know, they're going to go with agents. They can recommend they go back too. What are your priorities? You know, Wendell Carter, this particular year, received coaching from Mike Krzyzewski. How much would it cost to rent Mike Krzyzewski for 7 months to coach you? Wendell Carter got hurt during the season. What about how much it would cost to get the training staff to take care of you? I don't know who the strength and conditioning coach is at Duke, but what about that individual that got you back into shape? Oh, and then, by the way, helped you along in the rehab you needed. How much does that cost? How much does that person cost? Who got you in shape all summer, all during the fall, and then if there's an injury, also was critical in your rehab. How much does that person cost to rent? How much does it cost to get a tutor? How much does it cost to get into Duke? How much does it cost to get meals on the meal plan at Duke? How much does it cost to have a room at Duke? How much does it cost to get books at Duke? You know, one by one, all these items start to add up as to what it costs in the real world. Okay? The real world. Okay? But he's starting to find that out. Now, he's going to make a lot of money, so he'll be able to pay all this off. But right now, he's got to get training, strength training, weight training, speed training. Okay? He gets hurt. He's got to take care of himself, off his insurance, whatever it may be. And think about all these things that you get. It's never talked about. You gotta have some sort of experience through this. You can't just sit in a studio and not get out into the real world. I hear these people talk about, well, they're just using these kids. Well, they aren't just, quote, using these kids. These kids are also in the system getting plenty of help that they don't have to pay for. That's never talked about. How much would it cost to have personal coaching from Mike Krzyzewski for 7 months? How much would that cost? Oh, that, which also comes with it, by the way, a staff. Just that part. How much would that part cost? How much does it cost to get a strength and conditioning coach that's been working with you since June? So how many months of rental is that in? A trainer. A tutor. Like an academic advisor. Uh, a Duke education, which you can go back now and get for free. Your books, your room, your food. You know, line by line, this all starts to add up. Okay? It's not so cut and dried as it's made out to be. I mean, that's just a one and done. You know, take Tony Carr, for example. He went 2 years to Penn State. Well, how much is it? You know, so he's at Penn State. Let's see. Let's just say till March 31st. All right. You know, let's just take it to that point. So March, April, May. April, May, June. So he was at Penn State a total of 21 months. So he got 21 months of strength and conditioning that he didn't have to pay for. And I'm just using Tony as an example here. 21 months of a strength and conditioning program he didn't have to pay for. 21 months of having Jonathan Salazar a phone call away as the athletic trainer to take care of whatever injury he may have. Also, any rehab. Tony got hurt early in the season. Remember, he hurt his ankle in that game against Fairleigh Dickinson. All right, where a guy landed on it, turned it, and Tony missed the next game. All right. And then the rehab he had to go through after, you know, that they took care of him. If he really got hurt, he had Dr. Wayne Sebastianelli or Dr. Scott Lynch available to do the surgery. Okay. Meals. Nope. Training table all the time. Nutrition stations all set, ready to go. Room, 21 months, rent free over at the Nittany Apartments. Books. Yeah, you had to go down and get them, but they were all bought. Okay. Kellen is the academic advisor for Penn State. She's right there. And if he needed tutoring in any subject the last 2 years, it was available to get right away. Tuition. Now, he's in state. So he's in state. That's a big plus. Josh Reeves, for example, is out of state. Tuition is much higher for Josh Reeves than it is for Tony Carr. But in-state's no bargain. Out-of-state's very expensive. All of these items start to add up. Now, how much is 21 months worth of coaching? If you were to rent Patrick Chambers for 21 months, how much would that be? If you were to rent to work in the backcourt with you, Keith Ergo, and then this year to have really as your left arm in this, Jim Ferry, rent him for the last 10 months that he's been on the staff, how much would that cost you to teach you more about how to play the game? I mean, on and on and on and on and on. There's just so much of this here. You know, how much would it cost to rent a cold tub? How much does it cost to rent a hot tub, which is critical in the recovery process of anything? Just to practice, you need recovery. So there's so much here that nobody takes into account. They all should be paid. What? Okay, well, you know what? Well, then maybe out of the money you pay them, they ought to pay back all the stuff that they're getting for all this. It's like when the big cable thing happened years ago. CBS. And they threatened CBS and said, you know what? We're going to put on the cable bill exactly how much it costs to have you on there. We're going to put a line right there. CBS costs this much. Yeah, we don't want you to do that. We don't want anybody to know that. Let's just settle. But that's what this takes. It is not as simple as showing up and playing. Okay? Let's just take a practice. Okay? How much would it take you to rent gym time? They can go out in the gym anytime they want. How much would it cost them to rent gym time? How much would it cost them to not only rent gym time, but get people to come out with them to work against? These are all things that cost money in the real world. But it also, it's your responsibility and not everybody else's responsibility to determine whether you're going to go to the NBA or not. And then if you do, if you want your education, it's your responsibility to figure out how to do it. My goodness, it's the easiest time in the history of the world to find things out. You ever hear of Google? We'll come back with more in a moment on News Radio 1070 WKOK. Great to have you with us today. Keith Smith, RealGM.com, will join us tomorrow in the NBA playoffs. Celtics and Sixers are an hour away. Then later tonight, the Cavs and the Raptors. Boston and Cleveland lead their respective series 3-0. Pens play Game 6 tonight at home with the Washington Capitals. Also, the Jets play Game 6 tonight as well. Up 3-2 on Nashville. And the Phillies play the Giants tonight. 6:30 the airtime here on News Radio 1070 WKOK and on WKOK.com. Great to have you with us. Brought to you by Purdy Insurance. Market Street in Sunbury. Go to PurdyInsurance.com. Back tomorrow in the Sunbury Motors studio. Sunbury Motors, 4th Street in Sunbury. Sunbury Motors Q, it's 11 at 15 in Hummel's Wharf.
Your station for news, weather, business, and CBS Sports Radio. News Radio 1070 WKOK Sunbury and on WKOK.com.